Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will explain how to view a map area in a zoomed state, with built-in options in the map toolbar. In this example, the map area shows many data points. You may want to zoom into a specific area to view the data points there more clearly. So, select the specific map area to zoom in on. Now, I will show you how to enable and work with the zooming and panning options using my existing Blazor application. In my existing application, I already added a simple maps control with basic properties and added a GeoJSON shape of the world map in the maps layer. I set the t-value, the shape property path, and the shape data path properties to it. I have bound COVID-19 statistics data with an appropriate title for the map. I also enabled data labels and defined colors for the map shapes based on the severity level in the data source. If you would like to watch the video on how to create this Blazor app, follow the link provided in the card above or description below. Now, I will run this example by pressing F5. Here, you can see the Blazor maps control. Next, I will show you how to start zooming specific map areas. Within the map code, I define the map's zoom settings tag and set the enable property to true. Now, I will explain about the 5 different zooming modes of Blazor maps. In the first option, selection zooming, you select the map area to be zoomed. In the second option, mouse wheel zooming, you scroll the map area using the mouse wheel. In the third option, pinch zooming, you pinch to zoom in and separate your fingers on the map area to zoom out on touch-enabled devices. In the fourth option, single-click zooming, you click the map shape area one time to zoom. In the final option, double-click zooming, click the map shape area 2 times to zoom. To enable mouse wheel zooming, I define the mouse wheel zoom property and set its value to true within this map's zoom settings tag. Looking at the map output, you can zoom the map area using my mouse wheel or the toolbar zoom in option. By default, you will find the toolbar at the top of the map with zoom in, zoom out, and reset options. The reset option restores the map to its default view. If I want to customize the toolbar options, I first add a map's zoom toolbar settings tag and define the map's zoom toolbar button. Then, I define the list array, toolbar item list, and add specific values like zoom, zoom in, zoom out, and reset to it. Finally, I assign this list variable to the toolbar items property. As you can see, the map now displayed with custom toolbar items. Next, I will show you how to customize the buttons in the zooming toolbar. You can customize the zooming toolbar buttons using the properties color, fill, opacity, highlight color, and so on. For example, I define the border color and border width properties with appropriate values inside the map's zoom toolbar button tag. Looking at the map output, the toolbar button's border is displayed as green and with the custom width. Next, I will show you how to customize a tooltip for zooming toolbar items. To customize the tooltip in the zooming toolbar, I will define map's zoom toolbar tooltip settings tag within this map's zoom toolbar settings definition. Then, I will set a custom font color and font size for the tooltip by defining the properties font color and font size with appropriate values. Looking at the map output, while I hover over the zooming toolbar items, the button names are shown in a red color and custom size. Other customization options include changing the fill, opacity, border color, and so on. Here, the zooming toolbar options are displayed horizontally. Suppose I would like to make the toolbar vertical. Then, I add the orientation property and set its value to vertical within this map's zoom toolbar settings tag. You can see in the map output now, the zooming toolbar options are displayed vertically. Next, I am going to show you how to change the position of the zooming toolbar. You can align the zooming toolbar at far, near, and center positions using vertical and horizontal alignment properties. I want to align the zooming toolbar vertically far, so I add the property vertical alignment and set its value as far. Looking at the map output, the toolbar buttons are positioned vertically far in the map area. Now, I will show you how to customize the zooming toolbar. You can customize the zooming toolbar using the properties, background color, border width, and border opacity. I define the border width and border color properties and set appropriate values to them within the map's zoom toolbar settings definition. And now, the zooming toolbar displays with a red border and custom border width. By default, you can move the zoomed map area. But, if you want to prevent this, then, you need to set the enable panning option to false in this map's zoom settings section. And so, you cannot move the zoomed area in the map. By default, the zoom factor min value is 1 and max value is 10. In case I want to change the zoom factor range, I may need to use the min zoom and max zoom properties. In this video, we have seen how to zoom a map area in different zooming modes. We also saw how to customize the toolbar options and add a tooltip for toolbar items. Finally, we learned how to change the position of the zooming toolbar. If you would like to see a working example of the map in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link in the description where you can see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazor products through our community license. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.